And ready to match the stars, Foster Brooks, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Lorna Patterson, Dick Martin, and Betty White, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 79. And now, here's the star of Match Game 79, Gene Raver.
My money's missing.
Hold everything.
Hold everything.
What?
Because we're fortunate to have with us an undercover security agent right here. Lieutenant Brooks, sir, will you make yourself known?
What are you going to do here?
I'd like to figure this thing out. Young lady, if you come over here, please. I must search you. Miss White, over here, please.
You're the one nearest the victim.
I have every reason to believe that.
You were the one nearest the victim,
weren't
you?
Coming over here.
Yes.
I'm going to have to search her. I hope you'll excuse me just
a second.
When they stop here.
Well, don't stop. I'll write a check.
I'm going to stay up for the newspaper.
Now, he was very convincing, wasn't he?
He pushed the first beat.
I didn't have the right feel for the whole thing.
All right, let's say hello to our two players here, Daisy Jameson and Quay Snyder. Current champ with $600 to her credit. And Quay, how are you doing here? Where are we here? In the middle of round one. You've had your question. Right. Hadn't matched any of our stars. Yeah. Are you ready to carry on?
Carry on.
Okay, we'll carry on here. Now, Daisy, this is your first round question. Did you hear that they just uncovered the tomb of King Tut's fat brother?
Oh, no.
Yeah. His name was King Blank. Just uncovered the tomb of King Tut's fat brother. His name was King Blank. Right. Get it in there. Perfect. I don't know what took you so long. Daisy? Did you hear that they just uncovered the tomb of King Tut's fat brother? His name was King...
That's it.
King...
A little louder.
Tut.
King Tun. These Chinese girl, very clever. She say King Tun. T-O-N.
Not the, what you put in your mouth.
Well, they should take this Roger and get rid of him. He's been a mess since last week when he ate the blue ink and everything.
He wrote King Tongue, T-O-N-G-U-E.
Oh, my.
She said King
Tongue.
And the design, cocktails for two, was not Brett's answer. It was mine from the last day.
Right, that's right.
The whole thing is askew.
Aren't we all? Now, let's get on with it here. King Tut's fat brother, his name was King...
Tub.
Tub!
You started to say that.
King Tub.
She started to say that.
Yeah. Tun is what she said, though. Yeah.
Tun is a terrific answer. I wish I'd started it.
Tub is excellent.
Well, I said
Tub is probably the definitive answer.
Tun is
good. Right?
I said King Butt.
King Butt.
There you go.
Okay. Uncover the tomb of King Tut's fat brother. His name was King...
King Butt.
Yeah.
Tub.
Tub it is. All right. Got a lot of those.
No. Yeah. The definitive answer
is
because what you say to old fat people, King Tut Tut.
Uh-huh. Tuck, tuck, tuck. Must need that extra piece of bread. Yes?
You didn't have to fake your way out of that. I didn't. My only hope is to faint right now, because into each life a little dull must fall, and I couldn't think of any. I said, King Kong. I don't want to discuss.
King Kong. Wait a minute.
King Kong is all right. No, King Kong is a very large, hefty, overweight person.
So here we are at the end of round one, and neither one of you has done anything yet, but you will later. Right now, this for you. Oh, this show's hot as a pistol, I tell you. Okay. Now, Quay, you can have A or B.
We'll take A, Gene.
We will. Okay, we will. Anything you say, Quay, is okay. Lazy Louie is really lazy.
How lazy is he?
He just filled out a job application. Under physician wanted, he wrote blank. Okay. Good. Have you been thinking about this, Quay? This is a very good question. Lazy Louie's really lazy. He just filled out a job application. Under position wanted, he wrote blank. Quay, I am speaking to you. Under position wanted, he wrote
nothing.
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 What? I beg your pardon. He said A.
Yeah.
And I gave him B?
Yeah.
Well, what do you want me to do about that? Should we throw this one out and give him another one? Does it matter to you?
Oh, sure.
Do you care whether it's A or B?
I'd rather have A.
You'd rather have A? Okay. Here is A. In my hand, I have A. This is A.
Should we do the fire sketch again?
No. This is it.
Throw away your answers.
Yeah, throw away those answers.
Yes.
Here it is. This is A, Quay.
I want to hear this question before I throw my answer away.
And if you don't get this, we can go to C.
Yes. Tom said, my wife really has a strange figure. When she wears a striped dress, she looks like a blank. My wife has a strange figure. When she wears a striped dress, she looks like a blank.
Got it.
Okay. Now, Quay. Tom said, my wife really has a strange figure. When she wears a striped dress, she looks like a...
tub.
A tub.
Just give him B back.
Yeah, that's right. Here we go. Lazy Louie is really lazy. No, he says tub.
Ask him if he wants to go back to A. Three games ago, he even won.
She wears a striped dress. She looks like A...
lying down.
No, that was B.
That's the one you threw out.
That's the one we threw out.
Oh, excuse yes. me. She looks like a barber pole.
Barber pole. Okay. What do you got there?
Daughter of barber pole.
Two barber poles. That's good. If she had a strange figure, it's quite interesting.
I set an awning at the Bonaventure Hotel.
Aha! Wonderful. Okay. Quay, we come down here to Lorna. Strange figure, my wife.
Who was wearing a striped
dress.
Blouse.
That's right. She's wearing stripes.
With a little ice cream.
With a little ice cream.
There's a bite taken out.
Oh, someone bit you right there.
On the ice cream.
Let's hear it for that person.
All right.
Are you reading? Okay.
Yeah. If she wears a striped dress, she looks like a...
I went for the obvious. Zebra.
Zebra.
Two zebras.
Two zebras.
Wait a minute. This should have been with the nurse an hour ago.
Excuse me.
What do you think?
Dick, that looks pretty thin. You better run it through again.
Well,
this is the nice hospital I've ever...
of it is.
I'm Dr. Malone.
All right. Now, nurse, whose turn is it? Nurse, on the end, the lady in white.
This is an emergency. I said a Venetian blind.
A Venetian blind.
All right.
Okay.
Nobody
said tub, Quay. Too bad. Well, you can't win them all. Now, when we get back from this commercial, it'll be very easy for you. All you got to do is match one to win another game. Now we got this.
Star Gene Rayburn.
Okay, Johnny O. Davey's won the $500. Means the least he'll play for is 10 times that amount or $5,000. However, she's going to spin the wheel. And if she has a lucky spin of the wheel, she'll double it up and play for $10,000. It's all yours, my dear. Go up there, and we'll all root for a double for you. And let's see how you do. Ready? Go. Bing. Oh, is that close? Another half inch.
Well, you got a break.
Yes. All right, Brett, there you go.
Oh, blue twice in 1 week. I don't know if I can take it.
Over here. That's it. All right. Good luck to you. This is for $5,000. Ready? Blank conditioner. Okay, now Brett is finished. Daisy, if you give us the answer she's given us, why, you will get $5,000. What do you say to that?
I say air conditioner.
You say air conditioner? Why are you laughing? Why are you laughing?
What did she say?
What did she say, hair conditioner?
No, she said air conditioner.
Oh, damn. I said air conditioner.
We welcome you, and before we start the game, we'd like to get a little acquainted with you and find out where you're from and what your vital statistics are or anything you want to tell us.
Well, you're welcoming me from Las Vegas, Nevada.
Las Vegas.
Yes, I'm employed by a brokerage. We deal in sound equipment, professional sound equipment for stage reinforcement. And I love to play games, and I'm glad to be here.
Well, we're delighted to have you. Do we have any games that she'd be interested in playing? You
Dan
think?
Has some games. Martian,
you have a game?
I got a dandy.
What's that?
And I got a good game, too.
Dana, you say you're connected with a company that has sound equipment. You're the ones that ruin our eardrums with all...
No. This is, like I said, sound reinforcement for stage.
Oh, for theatrical stuff. Body mics and all that?
Yes. Monitors, well, mixing boards.
Now, we have to frisk her to make sure she hasn't got a body mic on, don't we?
Looks like a job for Inspector Moore.
Oh, yes, sir. I guess we don't have time for any frisking there. Besides, it's my show anyway. Listen, we can't start at this moment. We got to do a little business with America. You sit right where you are. Right now, we have this for you.
All right, here we go. Thank you, one and all. Now,
you want A or B, Daisy?
Give them both up.
Do I want A or B?
Yes.
Suppose I want A.
You can't have A because he had A.
If you're B, then
yes. Here it is. Helen said, my boyfriend does everything the hard way. Yesterday, he tried to scratch his back with his blank.
Here is Angela.
Right here.
No, All right, here we go, Dave. Helen said my boyfriend does everything the hard way. Yesterday, he tried to scratch his back with his blank.
With his
what?
With his feet.
Feet?
Uh-huh.
Is that what you say?
Yeah.
Feet. Tried to scratch his back with his feet.
Mm.
You know, I got the feeling we're going to end up in a scoreless tie here.
And as it turns out.
Yes. What do you got here?
I had elbow.
Elbow is a good one. Elbow is very difficult because it can't be done.
No, I was thinking more like this, and then I thought about how limber I am now that I've been taking the dance class. It didn't seem so hard to me. Nose.
Nose, okay. One elbow, one nose.
She has misled the country in thinking she is up to her you-know-what in dance. She has 1 half-hour dance lesson. The 15 minutes she had to lay down at a town of table.
Bar now. Do my stretching.
You've been working your bar here for 6 years. I yeah. said big ton, tub, tut, and then settle for toe.
Okay.
That's a foot. That's a foot.
No, it's about an inch and a half.
It's part of the foot. It's about an inch and a half of the foot, but it's not the full foot there. What do you got here?
Elbow.
What do you got for us?
Here? I have foot.
Right there. Well, Quay, it was a pleasure to meet you. I have some gifts coming your way from Match Game 79. Many thanks for being here with us. Quay, excited.
Thanks a lot.
We're
rolling around here, Dave. 1.10.
Here it is. Here we go again. We polled a studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Come back blank. Come back blank. Remember, $500 for matching the most popular answer, $250 for the second, and $100 for the third. Whom do you call her?
Betty. Come back, little Sheba.
Okay.
Brett.
That's swallowed. Come back, Bill Bailey.
Okay, come back to me, sir.
Come back.
Come back tomorrow.
Okay. What time?
My life in trouble.
What time? Come back tomorrow. Come back, little Sheba, and come back to me are the three. You have the option of choosing one of those or giving us one of your own.
Come back, little Sheba.
Come back, little Sheba. What would you have said? You are not of one mind. Let's see if we have come back, little Sheba, up there in any position. May we see the $100 number? Come back to me. Very good. Okay. Let's see if little Sheba's under the $250 number. Soon it is. Yeah. All right. Last chance for you, Sheba. Where are you, you rascal? Come out, wherever you are. Yeah. Very good. All right, Daisy. Tying up $1,200. And we're going to stop right now and do a little business with America. You keep bouncing along there, honey. Okay. Where were you? Where did you go?
Yeah, no, I went to the Lou.
Take his bottle to the...
No, you didn't.
The Lou Grant Show.
Yeah, oh, I right. see. Lou
Do
Grant.
We have time to take for his the fire sketch?
No, we don't.
You have to take his glass to the nurse.
No, what we do have time is to say next week on this stage, some of you will be here and some of you will not be here.
Oh, darn it.
These are the ones who will be here.
Nipsey Russell. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly, Lonnie Anderson, Jack Jones, and Joyce Beulevant.
Gene Reverend here. Join us next time for Match Game 79. You were all wonderful.